بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. So brothers and sisters, one of the objectives of fasting, as mentioned in the Quran, is to attain taqwa, to attain righteousness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ. O you who believe, fasting has been made mandatory upon you, كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ, just as it was made mandatory upon the people before you, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so that you may attain taqwa. Now, what is taqwa? There are various opinions in regards to the precise definition of taqwa. But a loose translation is generally the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the respect and the awe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, piety, righteousness, being mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In essence, the ulama say taqwa is to develop an inner feeling, an inner quality that motivates a person to always obey the Creator, the Lord Almighty, and that inner feeling pulls a person away from sin, evil, and all forms of disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is in essence taqwa, to be mindful and aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he mentions some statements of the pious predecessors in regards to the importance of taqwa and the benefits of having taqwa. He quotes here Ibn Aun, who was approached by an individual in regards to the question of taqwa. So he said, عَلَيْكَ بِتَقْوَى اللَّهِ. He said, it's important that you embrace the fear and the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِنَّ الْمُتَّقِي لَيْسَ عَلَيْهِ وَحْشَ. For indeed, the person who has taqwa will never be in the state of frustration. You see, when a person is obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they're doing the right thing, they have nothing to fear in terms of harm, in terms of failure, in terms of facing a consequence that is negative, because one is pleasing the Creator and the Lord. When does a person fear? When they've done something wrong. When does a person fear frustrated or feel guilty? Is that when they have made an error, when they have disobeyed Allah, when they have gone astray, when they have forgotten certain commands, etc. So Ibn Aun says that when you have taqwa and piety, there would never be a sense of frustration or fear or guilt upon you. Why? Because you know you did the right thing. Another statement that is being mentioned by Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim is on the authority of Zayd ibn Aslam radiallahu an. Kana yuqal, and it was constantly attributed to him that he made this statement. Man ittaqillaha ahabbahu an-nas. The person who fears Allah, the people will love him. Wa in karihu, even though they may dislike it. So what this means is that a person who has taqwa, Allah will allow the people to love that individual. A person who fears Allah, Allah has the power to make people turn to him. And a person who fears people, then they will definitely fall into the frustrations and the negative circumstance and the situations with people. So even though there might be some people who dislike an individual who has taqwa, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make people love the individual, because it's the taqwa that brings people together. It's the taqwa that attracts people towards the mercy and the blessings of Allah. The Prophet ﷺ was a man of taqwa, obviously, because he was the Prophet. It's mentioned in many narrations that he was very simple and he would sit with the companions. There was no elevated place or position for the Prophet, peace and blessings upon him. He didn't have a throne. He didn't have servants and slaves with him. He was very simple. And when the people would come, they couldn't recognize the Prophet, peace and blessings upon him. They would say, Ayyukum man minkum Muhammad? Who amongst you is Muhammad? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then they would point at the Prophet, peace and blessings upon him. And the people say that we felt a sense of respect and awe as soon as we saw the Prophet, peace and blessings upon him. And we could not look straight into the eye of the Prophet, peace and blessings upon him, because of the nur and the brilliance and the illumination that emanated from his auspicious face. So again, this is part of that taqwa that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enables respect, awe, and honor to be blessed to such an individual. Imam al-Thawri once spoke to Ibn Abi Dhi'b, and he told him, "In ittaqaita Allah kafaka an-nas." If you fear Allah, if you have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're mindful of Allah, then Allah will be sufficient for the people. "Wa in ittaqaita an-nas lan yughnu 'anka min Allah shay'a." And if you fear people, then there would be never something that would suffice you in contentment and in peace. So when we please Allah, it's only one being we have to please. When we try to please humans and other people, there's so many people that we can't please. Someone might want it a certain way, another person wants it a different way. When it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're pleasing only Him, you do it His way, and automatically Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring the love of the people in regards to that individual. Sulaiman ibn Dawood, so this is the Prophet Sulaiman, who is the son of Dawood. It's recorded about him that he said, "Utina mimma utiya an-nasu wa mimma lam yu'tu." He said that when it comes to what we have been given, it's a sense of distribution from the Creator. He's given us some of the things that people have, and he's not given us some of the things that people have. "Wa 'alimna mimma 'alima an-nasu wa mimma lam ya'lamu." There's some knowledge that the people have, we don't have. And there's some knowledge that we have and the people don't have. "فَلَمْ نَجِدْ شَيْئًا أَفْضَلَ مِنْ تَقْوَى اللَّهِ فِي السِّرِّ وَالْعَلَانِيَةِ." But in essence, the greatest blessing of Allah that can be honored to an individual is the sense of being mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, having taqwa. In what? "فِي السِّرِّ وَالْعَلَانِيَةِ." In secret and also in public. Sometimes an individual behaves very well in public or in the presence of people. But when they're in the seclusion, when they're in privacy, then they're not mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They're not mindful of the commands and the duties that are laid down upon an individual. So taqwa is, whether a person is in private or whether a person is in public, a person is mindful of the laws and the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he continues and he says, "وَالْعَدْلُ فِي الْغَضَبِ وَالْرَضَى." That another important quality to have is to be just, whether a person is angry or whether the person is in joy. So if a person is in joy, it's very easy to be just. However, when a person is angered, when a person is in rage, it's difficult to be just. So the instruction here is that whether a person is in a pleasant situation or in a difficult or an angry situation, a person always has to be fair and just. وَالْقَصْدُ فِي الْفَقْرِ وَالْغِنَى. And to be balanced and moderate, whether a person is in poverty or whether a person is wealthy. And then the last statement he makes here is that when it comes to the concept of zuhd and taqwa, وَفِي الزُّهْدِ لِلْإِمَامِ أَحْمَدِ أَثَّرَ إِلَهِ. He has made a mention of Imam Ahmad here, rahimahullah, that there is a statement recorded in one of his works. مَا مِن مَخْلُوقٍ اِعْتَسَمَ بِمَخْلُوقٍ Duni illa qata'tu asbab as-samawati wal-ardi duna. Summary of this is that when a person holds firmly onto Allah, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the asbab, the creations, subservient to that individual. But if a person severs their relationship with Allah, then all the creations of the skies and the earth, they will not work in favor of this individual. وَإِن سَأَلَنِي لَمْ أُعْطِهِ. And if a person doesn't have this connection with the Creator, then when they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then perhaps it might not be blessed to them. وَإِن دَعَانِي لَمْ أُجِبْهُ. If they call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may not respond. وَإِن إِسْتَغْفَرَنِي لَمْ أَغْفَرْ لَهُ. If this person seeks forgiveness, perhaps Allah may not forgive. وَمَا مِن مَخْلُوقٍ. On the other hand, any creation that holds firmly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, duna khalqi, and does not depend on the creation. Depends on Allah, not the creation. Illa dhamantuhu as-samawati wal-ard. Allah says that He makes the heavens and the earth subservient to this individual. فَإِن سَأَلَنِي أَعْطَيْتُهُ. If this person asks Allah, then it is certain that Allah will accept. وَإِن دَعَانِي أَجَبْتُهُ. If this person calls upon Allah, Allah responds. وَإِن إِسْتَغْفَرَنِي غَفَرْتُ لَهُ. And if a person seeks forgiveness in this state, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive. So in essence, taqwa is that we are always aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we put our full trust and connection with the Creator, then everything around us becomes subservient to us. So we want to develop this taqwa, and we want to develop this awareness. And fasting is one of the methods to attain taqwa. What are we doing when we're fasting? We're creating a sense of discipline. And this is what taqwa is, that we are tempted to eat, but we don't eat because we are fasting. We are tempted to drink, but we don't drink because we are fasting. And in essence, this is what taqwa is, that we are tempted to do sin, but we hold ourselves back. When we look at the literal meaning of taqwa, it comes from taqiyah, which means to abstain. And this is what fasting is, to abstain, al-imsak. So we want to develop a sense of discipline and self-control. And, you know, I read an article by a philosopher, and he says one of the best qualities that any successful human being can have is self-control. And then he's giving examples of so many successful individuals in terms of the worldly life, in terms of the success of the material and positions. And he says that I've studied all of these people, and one common factor I find in them is they have self-control. Right? So taqwa is to have self-control. When to understand that I need to stay away. When to know I need to proceed. When a person doesn't have the sense of taqwa and being mindful, then they end up doing things that are inappropriate, or they lack doing what they're supposed to be doing. So taqwa will energize. It'll be the engine to engage in doing what is right and refraining from the wrong. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who are the muttaqeen, who have righteousness and taqwa. And we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable our fasting to give us this quality of taqwa and piety and righteousness. And may Allah bless us with the best of success in this world and the hereafter. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulihi Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka anta samiul alim. Wa tub alayna maulana innaka anta tawwabur rahim. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun ala al mursaleen. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, bi rahmatika ya rahmatika.